They've all been reading your books, Bhagavad Gita.
Every week, Tantiti calls and asks if there is any new book that you've written from them. He's very greedy.
He's read all.
Realizes something of this, his beauty, his sweetness, his pastime, then he forgets everything. You did in your drama that Bilva, even he was with Krishna.
No, he was not doing it.
Oh, he was not?
No.
He saw them. He looks like Shamasundar.
Oh, so much.
Oh, but it's so good to hear this.
Yeah.
I won't be quiet, dude.
Any devotee here realize something of Krishna's beauty, past times. He didn't forget everything, but he acted like that. Even he was even with Nandama Krishna, but he was remembering that past times. It was not better to exhibit like
the play was not written under the direction of Srila Prabhupada or any pure
devotee. So something. And with that person, from where?
There?
You.
Me? We're going to miss you so much, Gurudev. We don't want you to go. We're very sad that you're leaving. I'm very sad that you're leaving.
But you're going to the war.
No.
We saw many
people.
Many
Then we will go to Sydney, to her father's house.
Yes, also.
They want that you should come to their house all the time.
But they have to their jobs.
Yeah.
In Hawaii, will you stay with Vrindavan Das?
Yes.
He's my old friend.
You know him?
He's my old friend.
Very good person.
Nice to meet you.
He was about to give up chanting and all these things. And now he is so energetic. He went to Vrindavan.
You're collecting all the souls.
Very now energetic.
How can we?
For 15 days, we were living together. At last, I was writing so much stuff. But in India cannot write in 3, 4, 5, 6 months. Or in 10, 20 days, I can write. On the bank of ocean.
Not so many of us to disturb you.
And his home is very beautiful, very peaceful. Very peaceful. Oh, yes. And on Maui, I have my friends are Chiranjit and Turiyadas. Turiyadas brought me to Krishna consciousness in 1960.
Yeah, gathering about 500 devotees.
We are like entering the Bhakta program now. After so many years of being disciples of Srila Prabhupada, now we're coming and seeing disciples. We have to rejoin the Bhakta program to learn all over again.
This was wish of.
So how can we please you in such a way that we can make advancement in our Bhakta program? But when you go,
as you are coming, hearing and preaching. Yes. So much helping in my mission.
That we would like to keep you here longer. There's some greed, because when you go, everyone becomes very sad. And you're like the sun going to different places at different times, you're setting, but when the sun sets from us, it's sad. So how do we keep you in your instructions so that it is always fresh in our heart?
Now you are also senior Lord, and you should try to serve your Guru.
But serving him,
in this life, you should realize something about this. Give more energy.
But he has brought us here to serve you. It's like serving him by serving you.
Sometimes we become weak and engaged totally life maintaining life. And thus devotional activities become secondary. Life maintaining is for devotional services. Devotional services are not for maintaining life. Whatever we do, we should do to please Krishna, for the benefit of Krishna. If you are going to sleep, why I am going to sleep? You should think it. If my body will take some
rest.
I will sleep. For this, not for giving rest for this. If I am taking something not to provide this body, why? This body is for this, not mine. I have surrendered this body. So I will have to take care of this body to serve Krishna. All thoughts should break. I have come here not to obtain anything for myself, to please my Guru Varga, or Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Do you see what he did?
Otherwise, I was very good in Vrindavan, chanting the name of Seva Guru Radha, the place of Narasimha, in the bank of on the right. Bank of Radha Krishna. I only came here to fulfill the desire of all people.
others would also. You will sometimes remember us also in your travel, that we can otherwise we have no mercy.
Your Gurudev remembers you all or not?
Yes.
Remember?
That's why he sent you, so that we could.
That is why he has sent you.
So that we also have to be smart enough to know that we don't know what Krishna wants. We'll only know what Krishna wants through what you tell us what Krishna wants.
Gurudev, do our gurus always want us to leave off, to be ready to leave off everything and go to Vrindavan? Or is it that sometimes they want us to wait and go slowly to stay in our household life, in our occupation?
Don't lose your friends.
Don't lose what?
As much as possible. Very soon. No certainty of this body. Javata na pate anumitta java. Nise shaya sarvata khadushya. No certainty. No guarantee. Tomorrow this body will be possible. Why is this? But according to your state, don't jump your position, your state.
You can see that stage maybe better than we can see that stage. So we should wait for that call when it comes.
Oh. It depends on your state. Bilva Mangam, only one dash. Push.
One push.
By the words of Chinta. In a second he left. No delay. One day you will have to give up. Why late? But your standard will come.
But if we leave and we're not so spiritually advanced, then we may fall backwards again out of some prestige of trying to renounce early.
When I left my home, relatives, wives, children, father, mother, position, everything. At that time I was like a mad. I could not control and check. At once, quickly, in a moment. They wanted to check me. Myself. If I was now what I am, who I have not left all these things, I was in family. But no family life and renounce order for me or same thing. No different. Anywhere I can.
You have bigger
be like
family.
This. But at that time it was good for me. I became mad told you. And came in the guidance of my guru. I'm very lucky, very lucky that all the senior disciples of Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami, all were present. And I have sucked them. And I have heard their harikatha. They have so much affection for me. Fully they showered their mercy to me.
come and show the mercy to all the families, and all of our families are also engaged so nicely by this, so they're good associations.
Why he came to all these places? What to gain? And what he gained? Never. Oh, gain was that Krishna will be here.
So if we come, he will save a place for us? Huh? If we leave sometime, he will save a place for us?
If he comes to Vrindavan, you will have a place for him.
Yes, yes. Vrindavan is transcendental. Whole world can come one dust of Vrindavan. No more. And Krishna will support him.
So there is hope.
But when you go to Vrindavan, you think, oh, when I will return to my place? For general person, not for devotee. Raghunath Das Goswami will not return. Rupa Goswami will never return. But a person of general, they will go with so much
enthusiasm.
And when there will be 2, 3, 4 days, then I will be.
So we're only ordinary devotees, so how we do this? They are great devotees, we are simply just a speck of useless devotees. How will we get that strength to be? To again have that loyalty, desire and strength to do this.
So when only one desire will be that, oh, I should serve Krishna, then go. Then anyone cannot take you out of it. Some desires other than serving of Krishna, then they will take you. So it depends on you. Krishna mercy is always to all. Showering mercy for all. But we should take
mercy. So you will beat that desire out of us for anything other than Krishna?
You will. Then all the other desires will leave except the desire to serve Krishna.
Oh, Krishna will be nice.
Process for
you
development.
Know that at the time of that Prabhupada, all were bachelor.
Yeah, all of us were pretty
Prabhupada,
much
bachelor. Their guru wanted that they should be in family life.
No. Myself included.
In this world,
he would be,
not have allowed them.
We would have been. Especially we had someone said more association, probably would not have.
That is why he left this world. Oh, now they are not wanting to have no desire to serve, obey my orders. Quickly, when he knew, quickly. Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati also, he has told the Bhakti will not have. And he realized that, oh, they are not now. Now they are grown up and they want to control me. Not to control by me. And then quickly went to serve.
So now we can see, those of us at proper disciple, we've got second chance. First chance we've missed.
Your Gurudev and Krishna will give you. Sure. I think that they are not deviated. Those who have given the line, left the line of Swamiji. They are deviated. Whether they are in small leaders or in not obeying. But I think they are in line. Surely. Very not nothing. Very simple. Very simple. But to desire to serve Krishna, oh, this is mental. Anywhere. But continue to do. Even anyone like Bilvamanga, he goes to prostitute. No heart. Apichesu duracharo. Always or try to remember something. Have a time to remember all this. Read Gita, read Chaitanya. Don't always engage in maintaining it. If so, then we are all animals. And animals, not cows and bulls, hogs and fish.
Gurudev, what about Gurudev? What is the responsibility of mothers for their children, or us born in a female body?
Marcy tells.
He's telling, what is the responsibility of mothers for the children?
That we should serve Krishna. His eternal service of Krishna. Not my child. I will have to help.
Okay.
Not attachment. No attachment. That is my son. He is not your son, actually. He is a servant of Krishna.
Go back here.
This is the responsibility of a chaste husband, chaste wife, mother, father, guru, and all. Those who cannot help anyone to serve Krishna. They are not father, they are not guru, not brother, not uncle, not anything. Wow, husband. So nowadays it is anywhere.
The sadhu's mercy is to admonish us that in every circumstance, we must never give up Sadhu Sangha Nam Kirtan Bhagavad Sri Lanka.
Yes. This is the highest process. It can give very strong Krishna. Always be careful of offenses. Dash Nama Parad, 10 kinds of. This will ruin it. Otherwise, anyhow, you are chanting, remember, in sadhu sam, pure sadhu sam. ISKCON leaders honor you. They gave honor, proper honor to you all.
ISKCON leaders, they respect you.
No.
They won't let us preach in the temples anymore.
They have banned me not to go to any of their center. And if you are going, if I'm going, I'm destroying their disciples. Like Hiranyakashipu told for
But the trouble is, when you go to the temple, they see the real thing. And then the there's like the emperor's not wearing any clothes. They can say we're advanced, but they see someone that's advanced. So then what can they do? Then all the people want to come to you. So then they say you must not come. That's what they're fearing. And they're fearing anyone else who comes and tell them, oh, you should come. Yes.
They don't want that their disciples should advance in Krishna consciousness.
If they're banning you from the temples, they're also banning us because we're following in your line.
That is going on. That declared totally. That anyone associated with Narayana Maharaj, they are banned to come in our border of our center. They will all destroy. If they are going to hell, no harm. If they are going to Radha Kunda Babaji, no harm. If they are becoming nonsense, stupid, no harm. If they are going to be Babaji, no harm. But don't go to him.
But their advancement is stopped. They can only go so far. They can't go further. All they can do is ban. They can ban only. They can't give anything higher than banning.
So after a while, anyone who is sincere, then I think Krishna in their heart will give them a chance to come in your some tour at some point, or meet
not
some devotee.
Not who they meet, but any qualified or bona fide sadhu.
But I think in one sense, Krishna was also very kind to you, not allowing you to be involved in this conflict. Because there's so much problems, your whole time would be wasted in trying to patch holes in the fix the holes.
Giving time to
So this sangha that you have created is a lot like what our Guru Maharaj started when he came.
Yes.
The devotees are, your disciples are very sincere. And we see as older God brothers, they're much more sincere than us. They're making nice advancement. So this is reminding us when Prabhupada came, in the very early times, when everyone was very enthusiastic and following. Not like the late times when everyone is trying to decide which part of the world they're going to get for themselves once Maharaj leaves, or Gurudev leaves. So you please, any of us older daughters, you please root that nonsense from our brains so we don't make mistakes again.
In my classes, I never criticize them, anyone. Always Hari Katha, your Hari Katha. Not to criticize them.
So
I think that all the disciples of Swamiji, like children, they can come and make a stool here. I should bear it. I should.
So many devotees are pray very sincerely. So many devotees in this kind pray for someone to come to help Prabhupada's movement. Many of the devotees are very sincere. The general mass of devotees are very, very sincere to want to help out. This kind is their only facility. And so,
real, this one, who are? Krishna Bhakti Rasa Bhavita Mati Kriyatan Kuto Pijadila Tatra Lollama Kavi Aram Jan Kuti. Bhaktivedanta Swami has written that who are Eskon really? Oh. What is not achieved by thousands and thousands of life by practicing regulative bhakti? Low means greed. If anyhow, a person is very fortunate, if a greed, strong greed has come in his heart, oh, I want to serve Krishna in Vrindavan like Gop and Gopi, this grid is fine. Or if a grid has come to any devotee, or really he is otherwise no. By this we can judge Nardvaji's home, Vyaswaji's home, Sukhdev Goswami's home, Ishwarpuri Bhad, Madhvendra Puri, where is gone, Rup Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, up to Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, my Guru, Deva Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. They are really ISKCON. And those who are not following, who have not greed to desire to serve Krishna like Brajavasi, they can earn money. Very expert in money. No. Only they have learned this thing, this art to make money. Very funny. Very smart. They can wonderful. If you will give them to count the webs of sea, from there they can make
money. Yeah.
In sand, in desert, they can make money. They know all these arts.
So you are the answer to these devotees' prayers. This is so obvious, isn't it?
Yeah.
Is the answer, you are the answer to all of those sincere devotees praying for some person to come. Thank you.
I don't know.
He's telling you are the answer for the prayers of all the devotees, that someone will come and really inspire everyone to understand the mission of Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj.
My instruction is that never criticize anyone. Don't waste your time. Always chanting, remembering, reading the books of authority, and that's engaging your whole sense of this.
But Srila Prabhupada told us, work now, samadhi later. So many of us didn't become as studious in the philosophy. He gave everything, but he left us on our own to learn. So we worked very hard for the mission, and then our senior godbrothers and that tried to split up and cut Prabhupada from it.
Now they are going to atheist
university.
Because they have no faith in their guru words. They have no faith in Bhakti. We have some strong faith in name and in the instructions of
the responsibility of all of Srila Prabhupada's disciples to become infected with that lovium, so that we can infect others.
So the responsibility of all the disciples of Srila Swami Maharaj, Prabhupada, is that they will develop this eagerness, this greed,
yes.
Yeah, and then affect others.
Especially you, sinners, those who have realized this fact.
Is there still hope for us?
And I think that by doing so, your Guru will be very happy. Because it's everywhere, in your heart, everywhere.
But is there still hope for us, since we are still...
Surely. Don't be hopeless. Don't be
hopeless. Nithyananda, they asked Srila Prabhupada, how can we please you most? And he said, just learn to love Krishna.
Yeah.
I see sometimes this kind of camp mentality. I go both in ISKCON and here. And I think that we should try to not, at least here, not have this camp mentality, because we're falling into the game of politics. But if we really keep a pure desire to serve Prabhupada and to serve you, and avoid that camp mentality, we can spread Krishna consciousness all over the world, even with so many of our God brothers who might be in ISKCON. I don't think we need to see ourselves as two different groups that actually have one purpose, so therefore we're one group, even though we've become, you know, these subdivisions have been made. I know that there's many sisters.
He's telling that it seems that sometimes we develop the mentality that we are one group and they are another group, and that we cannot cooperate together, but we should not have this mood. We should think
always think that we are in family of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Only this.
Hare.
Hari.
This is Aditi from Alachua. She came all the way. She came from Alachua to see you.
Last year she met me. Yeah.
Alachua.
Yes. Also, Divya is here from Alachua.
And always the thing that we are all who are also not initiated, even not initiated, but chanting Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, and Radha Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Anyhow, they are in our family. And if initiated, oh, you should do enough. And give proper respect to them according to their stage. If he is not initiated by Gurudev, even if he is doing so, he is Vaishnava. Or he is in our family. If in the parivar of Nityananda Prabhu, Shyamananda Prabhu, you know Shyamananda Prabhu? Shyamananda Prabhu, Narottam Thakur. We are of Narottam Parivar. Some are of Shyamananda Parivar. Some are of Advait Parivar. So many. But all we are in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If they are chanting, remembering, they should be honored like Guru. Then know this trouble with. Then I can tell my disciples, oh, I'm not so high class of Vaishnava. Please go to that. And you should associate. And he will tell them, oh, I'm very happy that if you are helping my disciples. And that is why Swamiji told me, requested. And he told to all, what I'm saying, you should remember. He will help. I am requesting him to help you all. And he was happy. Not bad. Sadhu Sangha. And that is why they are losing their positions. And those who are sincere, they are
given. Gurudev? It seems through history there have always been those who are opposed to bhakti. Is that always a problem?
It says in history, when we study, then there are always those persons who don't want bhakti, who want to be opposed to bhakti. You mean in Vaishnava history?
In Vaishnava history. Is that an eternal problem? Always a problem?
Is this a problem of this material world? Yeah, that there will always be those who are not interested in bhakti. Even though they are in the garb of Vaishnavas?
Yes.
They are dressed like devotees, but they don't want bhakti.
Is always a problem?
For whom problem? For them it is problem. Not for any devotee. Prahlad Maharaj had no problem with his father. No problem. He was easy moving, going, chanting. Oh, Prahlad Maharaj was a problem from them, for them. His activities were a problem for himself.
But it seems over like the last 20 years that because the Vaishnav groups were fighting, now the Buddhists and so many other groups are trying to become prominent because we've not sincerely tried to spread so much the mission but quarrel amongst ourselves.
This is iron group. Krishna has empowered them to be prominent, most prominent. But they cannot do anything, those who are sincere. No problem. I realize those who are here, they are doing so much But no problem for us. We are preaching the word. We are chanting and helping others
also. Almost six o'clock.
And we should
sure, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
Thank you.
You're a static Harinam. Nice
Harinam. You know the statement you were just...
I've been taking from the mouth of devotees.
You know the statement you were just saying about the management, but we also think your disciples from San Diego have done a very wonderful job also.
Freely distributed.
Be ready.
Oh, we will. Huh. I was happy. Yes.
They will come and they will what? Make problems here, there. We know how.
Welcome anyway. It's nice.
Yes, you can take our house.
But you are only daughter. You can manage everything. If some are doing something, oh no heart.
She says you're her father.
No.
Tomorrow I'm leaving and I won't see you until you come to Eugene.
Very
good. And also, Ganadas Prabhu and Mandari are going to email me Jai the Dharma and I'll work on
very
it.
Very good. Just okay. Just okay. Don't baby like that.
I need an injection because
yes.
I feel weak.
I will bring Mota Wala injection. Mota Wala.
Mota Wala.
Take one.
A what?
Having so much in that city.
Yes. A fat injection.
Big.
Big. Fat injection. A baro size.
Baro.
Now we should all go to Baro.
What about the bringing so we can pull him out and it will be easier just for me to say
hello? We're hiding here in the back. The baby's not to see it, right?
No, they already did.
Oh. Okay.
Wait, you see it in the morning.
Come on, give me one. Dakshina. Okay. Very good, Dakshina.
I did sharing today.
Very good, very good.
Thank you.
know you from all.